on the button!
We're going to find somewhere new, somewhere exciting, somewhere uncharted!
It's an infinitely expanding multiverse, Meaney. It's almost entirely uncharted. Don't push that!
If we're not gonna get home anytime soon, we can at least turn this into a unique learning experience.
Well, that's a stupid idea.
It was your idea! You're the one who said it!
Yes, but that was mostly to get you to calm down.
It worked!
It got you worked up, that's what it did. This is just like the time Commander Thompson gave you some of her mega licorice. No, don't push it again! You can't keep pushing it over and over like that. You're going to misalign the tension converter.
What's a tension converter?
I don't know, I just made it up. Look, do you really expect to see anything new if you keep clicking past it like it's the news or yet another CSI spin-off? Just let the ship land somewhere, for Christ's sake.
You're right.
Yes, thank you. Now the ship can get her bearings and where are you going?
I'm going out.
What, out there?
Yes.
What, now?
No time like the present.
There's plenty of times like the present. Later, for instance, later bears a remarkable resemblance to the present. They're virtually identical.
You said it yourself, Lou. We should get out there, explore strange new universes, seek out new life forms and civilizations.
Eventually, yes. Not now, though, surely. We've just had a very stressful experience, what with those robots and the T-Rex and not one but two knives. We should rest and you're already outside? All right, fine. Guess this is happening.
This is amazing.
It's a cargo hold. Probably on some kind of spaceship or space station, or possibly, quite possibly, it's just a big empty warehouse.
I know. Isn't it incredible?
Have you not been to a warehouse before?
Look at these glass canisters, dozens and dozens of them, all stacked up. They're full of some kind of... what is that? Fluid? Energy? It's white. It could be plasma. Hey, do you have that little scannery thing?
I'm not wasting precious battery power scanning what may very well be milk.
But we should run some scans. Ask some questions.
There's only one question I want to ask. It's, what's the quickest way out of here? And seeing as the answer is the flurry, which is just over there, I don't feel a pressing need to...
Freeze! Either one of you move, you're dead.
Okay, we can leave now.
Over here! I found our intruders!
All right, step away from the cargo and we'll shoot.
Don't you mean, or we'll shoot?
Reckon my man Jasper said what he said.
Think they're here for the cargo?
Why else would they be here?
Weren't exactly working careful-like. Lit up our internals like Times New Roman.
It's Times Square.
What?
Times New Roman is a font. Times Square is the place that's...
I don't recall giving your mouth a hall pass, friend. So I'd suggest you send it back to class before Jasper here puts you in detention.
Oh, there's no need for this. You don't have a clue who we are.
Your defense is, don't shoot, we're strangers.
That's fair, actually. That's a fair point.
Look, we're not from here. I'm Meaney, he's Llewellyn. We're Bleeds. Basically, a sort of self-appointed reality police, and...
Ain't much care for who you are. More concerned with how you boarded my bidge.
Bidge?
My bidge? Bidge? Corruption of barge, slang for spaceship?
Spaceship, see? What did I say? I said it would be a spaceship.
You said it'd be a lot of things.
You best get to saying an answer to the question. Where'd you come from?
Well, when a man and a woman love each other very much...
I'm not sure that's what they meant, Lou.
I know, I was being pedantic.
You mean you were being obnoxious?
Now you're being pedantic.
Reckon I take him to Newman, let him deal with him. What'd you reckon?
Reckon that's a damn fine idea, Lloyd.
I reckon we show them an airlock.
You captain now? You making the calls?
They're in the cargo hold. Ain't no reason to be in here lest they was fixing to steal the goods. Could be a rival gang. Maybe one of the Ferret's boys. Kill them now before they get to causing us unwanted strife.
Cap's got his mind made, Jasper. Newman will put the fear of God into him.
Ain't no God left to fear, Lloyd. But Newman's the next best thing.
I'm sorry, are you all talking like this on purpose?
Damn, their whining's exhaustifying. Lloyd, take him down to security.
Sure thing, Phelan. When you say security...
Empty supply cupboard. Where we keep the paint?
That's what I thought.
You know, for a security department, this doesn't feel very secure.
I know. I get the need for the handcuffs, but wouldn't it make more sense if they handcuffed us to the chairs?
I don't even think these are real handcuffs.
You're right. Look, there's a release clasp on the side.
We could get up and leave this room whenever we like.
So why are we still here?
Well, you wanted to sate that curiosity of yours, didn't you?
What?
Come on, Meaney, didn't you want to get out there, explore strange new universes, seek out new life forms and civil servants?
Not anymore. Not if we're going to be held captive by people who don't even know how to take prisoners properly.
Well, I'm suddenly very keen to stick around. This all seems very odd, and there's tins of paint in here. What's that all about?
It's that Lloyd woman, isn't it?
Pardon?
You're into her. You think she's hot.
Not especially, no.
Oh, you liar! Look at her! Curves all over the place. Her hair's got that gently curly tussle thing going on. She's got wide eyes and shiny skin. Probably a thin layer of glistening sweat from working on board this slightly too warm spaceship all day.
Oh, come off it.
You seriously don't want to ask her out.
No, but you obviously do.
Come on!
Meaney, when have I ever shown an interest in a woman? Or a man, for that matter, or anyone? I'm not interested.
Oh, you're ace!
Yeah, I do my best, yeah.
All right, Nuggets, welcome to hell!
Oh, you're here finally. Look, before you start, you're the security guy.
Yeah?
And you're sure about that, are you?
What are you getting at?
Well, it's just I was expecting... Well, we were expecting, really. You know, the security guy would be a, you know, a big burly chap with great big Popeye the Sailor Man arms whose idea of interrogation means ripping limbs off one by one until you're, I don't know, screaming your Auntie Dot's rhubarb crumble recipe at them on the off chance that that's what they're after.
What are you trying to say?
I'm trying to say... How do I put this delicately?
Aren't you a little short for a security chief?
That's it, yes. Thank you, Meaney. Yeah, you are ridiculously tiny.
I am chief of security, and you will show me due respect.
We are.
Shut it! Now tell me what you're doing here on this here bench, if it weren't painfully obvious.
Well, the door isn't locked. The handcuffs aren't real. There's paint tins in your security room. My partner here is a sexless jerk on wheels. Nobody has said anything nice to me since I got here. I can't find my shoes, and your lady friend with the gun rack has the classic beauty of an Egyptian goddess.
You'll have to excuse my friend when she's trapped in a confined space with open tins of emulsion paint. She can get a little bit delirious and, bicurious, apparently. Any chance we could move this to somewhere a little less fumey?
You ain't going anywhere, friend.
Well, could you at least get rid of the paint? It smells like the bathroom of a goth nightclub in here.
You ain't exactly in a position to make demands, are ya?
What does a small cargo ship like this need an equally small chief of security for?
Oh, I'm guessing it's not a formal title. Guessing it's the thing he calls himself to feel a little less unimportant. The rest of the crew gets to dart around the ship with ruddy, great big laser rifles, and you're stuck in here with us.
Babysitting!
Yes! That's probably it. The insecurity is palpable. You could palp it from a 10-mile radius.
Shut your hole!
I bet you've named your gun. Probably has an old woman's name. Agnes, maybe. Beatrice. Beatrice is very in right now, isn't it?
I ain't the one handcuffed to a chair.
Neither are we.
What in the hell was that?
I'm no expert, but it sounded rather a lot like an explosion.
Don't be smart.
Why ever not? Someone's got to be, and it obviously isn't going to be you.
Oh, you son of a... Hang on. I should take this. Yellow!
Newman, bring the prisoners down to engineering. Something just blew a hole in our side, and I don't doubt they got fingers in this particular pie.
Copy. Reckon you got some explaining to do.
You lot say reckon way too much, you know that?
Quick system check, Cap. We're dead in the water and internal security is down.
Just our luck.
A thunder, Cap!
It's Alan, sir. She's pretty beat up.
I'm fine. Just cut up some is all.
Alan, what happened?
Main plasma manifold blew. Damn near knocked me for six. Service droids got a bubble over the breach, but... we lost Cutter.
No.
She's gone, Cap. Sucked out into the black.
Can we?
It's too late. She's gone. I'm sorry.
Wowzers! Look at the size of that hole breach. You could lose a person out there if you're not careful.
Keep talking, Sproutlet. I'm fixing to put a bullet twixt your peepers. We lost... someone. Someone precious just now.
You're not gonna find some way to blame us for this, are you?
I ain't the type to believe in coincidences. You two apparate aboard and suddenly we blow a manifold, taking a chunk out of the side of my bidge and knocking out internal security in the process. Not to mention costing me a damn fine and much beloved crew member.
My gut says two things are related.
Now your gut needs a second opinion. Who's she?
I'm Alan. Who's Alan?
She's the engineer.
I thought you were the engineer.
No, I'm the pilot.
Then who's the other guy?
I'm the muscle.
I thought I was the muscle.
I thought she was the captain.
No, I'm the pilot.
And I'm the engineer.
And I'm the captain.
Third base!
Lloyd, the cargo's safe?
Safe and sound, Cap. Stuff's volatile, but the ship shape didn't harm it none. Should be stable enough to make back home.
Are you talking about that stuff in the cargo hold? What is that stuff?
None of your concern. Right now, I want to know who you two are, who sent you, and what your plans are.
We should have Cusacked them back when we first found them.
Can't say I disagree with Jasper.
We ain't gonna flush them into the dark before we find out where they're from and why they did this.
We got all the answers we needed when they punched a damn hole in the side of the bidge.
It's my bidge. Well, maybe it shouldn't be your bidge.
Maybe you'd still have some bidge left if you showed a little spine.
Maybe someone needs to run this bidge proper.
I get that this is a tense moment, but you are all saying bitch way too much for me to take any of this seriously.
This mutiny, Jasper? You mutineering right now?
Reckon that's what's happening.
And how about the rest of y'all? Lloyd? Alan? Newman? You taking sides too?
I'm with you, Cap.
You've always had my back, so I got yours.
Sorry, Dylan, but Jasper's right. You ginnied up back in the hold and shot these stowaways, Cutter'd still be here, and she'd be thankful.
You don't get to say her name.
Well, she ain't here to object no more, now is she? On account of your weak leadership.
This is super awkward. I really feel like we shouldn't be here.
Finally, something we agree on.
No!
I'm hit.
We can see that.
Are you done?
God, I hope so.
All right. It was a bit much, is what I was going to say.
You didn't have to kill him, Jasper.
He weren't exactly living any. And now this bitch has an opening. Reckon I'll be a better captain than Phelan ever was. Dead man's boots, right?
You ain't got feet big enough for him.
Okay, did you actually say that? Like, with your mouth and everything?
God damn, you're irksome.
You want I should kill him, Jess?
No, I got a better idea. We'll drop him off on Xander. Let the Hellions deal with him.
I'm gonna guess by the name that the Hellions aren't famous for their hospitality.
They eat people's skins and wear their bones as armor.
What, leave all that muscle and blood? That's just wasteful.
You were ready to kill us, like, 90 seconds ago. Why the sudden change of tune?
Look, you gonna play along or what?
I'm not complaining. Don't get me wrong, it's just... odd, is all.
Alan?
What?
Fix the manifold.
I ain't doing a damn thing for you.
Will you do it for... Lois?
There's a Lois now. Oh, it's the gun.
See? Guns and old women names. I could write a dissertation.
Fixing the manifold ain't gonna be easy. Half of its bits floating in space.
I trust you got the skill set to work around that particular obstacle. Newman?
Sir?
Put Lord and our guests somewhere they ain't gonna trouble us none.
Yes, sir.
Anyone needs me?
Not likely.
Anyone needs me, I'll be on the bridge.
The bridge of the bitch.
Shut up! Get moving!
Hey, Blue.
Yes?
Chief of Insecurity.
That's pretty great, but perhaps a little mistimed.
Oh, right.
Oh, we're in here again.
He killed the cap! I can't believe that Bajingan killed the villain!
The what?
It's Indonesian. Everybody spoke it back then.
The paint's gone. They moved the paint out of the room.
Why would JjAR mutiny? It can't just be about us, can it?
It's been a long time coming. JjAR's never been satisfied with the pay we get from our, from the cargo. Always thought he could negotiate a better rate. Trouble is, you've already seen his best negotiator.
Lois.
That gun does most of JjAR's talking, and neither of them are any good at it.
Who moved the paint? Everybody was in engineering.
Listen, we're here to help. We're leads.
You mean like cables?
Like cross-dimensional police from a parallel universe.
Ah, yes. And...
and we can help you take back the ship. But to do that, we need to know what's actually going on. What's in those glass canisters in the cargo hold? Why is it so important to you?
And why does it look like jizz? Really? Nobody else was thinking that the white fluid in the cargo hold looked like semen? It's just me.
I mean, I wasn't going to say it, but...
That's not really the tone we're going for here. Besides, we found you in our cargo hold right by the merch. You think I believe for one second you don't know what's going on?
No! We don't know! We're from another dimension! We don't know anything about this universe, let alone what you get up on this junk heap budge of yours!
It's bidge! It's called a bidge!
That's stupid! It's a stupid, stupid word! Just tell us, okay? What's so precious about that cargo?
All right. We harvest energy from a nearby nebula, then we take it back to Earth. All we got right now can power the planet for months. But it's phototan energy.
So?
It's highly volatile, super unstable, and incredibly unsafe. Collecting the stuff is illegal, mostly because of how risky it is.
If it's so incredibly dangerous to collect, why go to the trouble?
She asked, apparently ignorant of 1,000 years of human history.
Earth's all used up. Ship like ours makes it back to Earth with a few canisters of phototan. They ain't about to turn away a good resource, even if they don't approve of how we get it. So we go into the nebula where it's naturally occurring and we help ourselves. Trouble is, we ain't the only harvesting operation. There's a lot of competition. The Ferrets, the Seven Stars, the Scapelli Brothers. It can get a little hostile out here in the black. Thought you might be a rival org.
If the Earth's resources are all gone...
used up.
I... Yes, of course, that. If that's the case, why not leave? Why not find new planets to terraform?
Oh, no one wants to do that. There's too much history there.
Well, that's bloody stupid. A planet's just a rock. There'll always be more rocks in the universe.
Maybe, but it's our rock.
That's quite touching, really. I bet that story was a favorite of Phillon's, right up until Jasper Carrot and the Chief of Insecurity blasted a hole in his torso.
You shut yours, else I'll shut it for you.
Yeah, and you stole my joke.
Well, I said it was a good joke.
Uh-huh, and then you stole it.
Some people don't know how to take a compliment.
Lloyd, what can we do? How can we help?
Well, we gotta take back the ship. Alan's on side, but Jasper's got her at the end of a gun barrel, and he'd shoot us before he'd let us open Ma. So
that makes Newman the weak link.
Exactly. The man's stupid as sin, but he has the self-preservation instincts of a tapeworm and a spine to match. If he sees the tide turn again, Jasper, he'll turn with it. Except, Newman took my gun, so we're unarmed.
Fine by me. I don't need guns.
I do. I'd love a gun. Preferably something big that makes, you know, a nice satisfying hum as it powers up.
Well, there's an armory close by if we can get to it. But that leads to our next problem.
Bring it on! There's nothing we can't accomplish if we work together!
We're locked in here.
Oh.
Before you ask, there aren't any ducts, vents, grates, grills, or panels we can remove to sneak out. The room is sealed.
I remember. The paint fumes just sort of accumulated. I'm still not convinced this isn't an elaborate hallucination. You're staring at me, Lou. What's wrong?
I'm just trying to work out if you're actually this stupid or if you've decided to play a role for kicks.
And just what is that supposed to mean?
This is the security room, where they held us the last time. You know, handcuffs with a release clasp, chairs we could easily get out of at a moment's notice, and...
The door's unlocked!
You can't just open the door!
Yes, I can! It was never locked! We could leave any time we like. Honestly, Lloyd, did it not occur to you to check?
Yeah, that's disappointing.
I thought you liked her.
I did, but the shine's gone off that particular apple.
If the door's open, we need to get to the armory ASAP! Come on! Duck!
Laser turrets?
Internal security system.
I thought that was down after the manifold blew.
Jasper must have been lying. Stupid son of a bitch planned this whole thing. Blown the manifold to stall the ship so he could shoot Phillon and seize power.
Of a ship with a hole on the side of it. That's a bit like becoming a ballet dancer's manager by cutting their legs off.
Jasper ain't one for a long game. He's a one problem at a time kind of guy, and he's pretty confident any problem can be overcome by shooting at it.
Well, if you're still planning on arming up, we need to get to the armory.
No, you need to get to the armory. I'm gonna create a distraction.
That wasn't the plan.
What plan? Hey, turrets! Your ma's a photocopier!
What?
Stop dilly-dallying and go! You all right?
Did you seriously say dilly-dallying?
Look at all this stuff. Plasma rifles, quantum blasters, smoke grenades. Is that a rocket launcher?
Huh. That explains the huge reinforced door. If it comes to it, we could hide in here indefinitely.
Yes. Well, unless those weapons are edible, I suspect indefinitely is somewhat optimistic.
You're right. We should come up with a strategy, a plan of action. Lloyd put herself on the line to save us, and now we owe it to... What are you doing?
I'm arming up. Smoke grenade, a couple of big guns. That should do it. Hang on. Oh, yeah, that's the stuff.
Oh, I get it. You're gonna head to the bridge of the bitch to get Jasper to budge from his grudge.
Yet nowhere in that entire string of words was there anything even remotely close to a plan.
Well, if you're going out there, I'm going with you.
Meaney, if you'd let me leave here alone, I would have kicked you in the shins on my way out. You ready?
No.
Good. On the count of three, I'll open the door. We'll each aim for one of the turrets in the hallway and then make our way out. One, two, three!
Ah! turrets aren't doing anything.
Yeah, I've noticed.
You think Lloyd shut the internal security system down?
Possibly. All right, let's go.
Where are you going? The bridge is this way.
Yes, but the flurry is this way.
We can't leave. Lloyd and Alan need us.
Yeah, I'm not entirely convinced they need anything. And even if they were, that's hardly a solid reason to stay, is it?
Don't their lives mean anything to you?
I've known these people less than 2 hours. I can barely remember their names.
Lloyd. Alan. Phillin. There's a cutter in there somewhere, I think.
Yeah, half of those people aren't alive anymore, Meaney.
Yeah? Well, half is a good place to stop.
Where the hell are you going?
If you want to go, then go. But I'm gonna try to help.
You can help. You can push the fast return button.
Goodbye, Llewellyn.
Don't think I won't jump without you. I don't like you, remember? Bastard.
And they invited us back to Northern next year.
Oh, that's radical. Hey, you going to the convention in Ontario?
Probably not. It's a heck of a drive. I just don't know if I have the stamina.
I know what you mean. Last summer I was invited out to a show on Regulus 7, and the shuttle flight? It was just a real bear. Next time I'm letting Topher drive so I can snooze in the back.
Nobody move!
Lloyd, we've got our sights on Jasper. You can back away.
Oh, we're doing this now? Here?
I thought we were on break. Aren't we supposed to be on a break?
I thought so, yeah.
What's going on?
Oh, nothing. We were just having sort of a friendly chit-chat.
But, and forgive me if I'm mistaken here, but you're supposed to be mutinying right now.
Yeah?
You threatened to kill us.
guilty.
And now Lloyd is just sitting with you, sort of chilling.
Oh, yeah. I've known this guy for years.
So, you're what? Working together?
I knew it. I bloody knew something was up. These slick gits with their space-wise gibber talk and their mysterious cargo. I mean, it was all so forced.
Yeah. Was it?
I don't know. I think we do a pretty good job of sounding authentic.
Oh, yes. It's very period. You sure these guys aren't with you?
No, they're not from my bunch. Excuse me.
Villain?
Hey, guys. Want some coffee?
What the hell is going on?
Wait. Are you not part of a group, then?
What group?
The reenactment group.
The reenactment group.
Yeah, we're reenacting the mutiny of the calming storm. It's a famous story. We do it every summer.
Yep, been doing it for, God, is it 17 years now?
18.
Oh, yes. I forgot about Warwickshire.
Are you serious?
It's for kids, mostly. A bit of history. My name's not even Lloyd. It's Sharon. And this is Dave.
Hey, what's up?
So, the lasers and stuff, it...
Well, special effects. Here, let me show you.
Huh. Went right through me.
Pretty cool stuff, huh? Yeah, the guns, the turrets, they're all rigged like this. Makes for quite the light show.
So, hang on. You didn't think it was strange that something that didn't happen was happening in your historical reenactment?
History's not a very exciting subject, so sometimes our corporate sponsors like to drop in some nonsense to spice things up. Last year it was, what did they do last year?
Killer alien.
Oh, yeah. Killer alien loose on the ship. Not fond of it myself, but it gets eyes on the show and, of course, helps us pay the bills.
Hey, are you really from a parallel universe? That's exciting.
There was never actually any danger, we could have just gone?
I suppose, yes.
Oh, but you really should stay, though. The ending's a real treat. It establishes how the mutiny spearheaded by Jasper...
Hey, that's me!
Yes. How that ultimately led to the establishment of the Great Treaty of Frutal, which allowed for peaceful trading of phonotine energy and the birth of a whole new Earth.
Ooh, that sounds fascinating.
No, thanks. I think we'll just go off and leap into the rear exhaust of a hyper freighter, if it's all the same to you. Come on, Meaney. We're off.
You don't happen to have any leaflets, do you?
Meaney?
Coming!
Well, that was a monumental waste of time.
I don't know, Lou. I've learned a little something from this experience.
Yeah, so have I. Never let you pick up pit stops.
Well, if nothing else, I got a little reading material out of it.
Little being the operative word.
So, what's the plan now? Still want me to see this as a learning experience? Or can we actually try to get back to the hub?
Whatever. I'm not particularly bothered. Besides, I highly doubt this sort of madness will happen every time we land somewhere.
Yeah, you're probably right.
You have been listening to Jump Leads Episode 2, Mutiny, written by Ben Paddon. Featuring the voices of Marissa Meizel, Ben Paddon, Amber Aviles, Kris Dorman, and Dino Andrade. Editing and sound design by Ben Paddon. The JumpShip engine sound was created by Shaun Lile. The theme music is by Professor Shy Guy. Find out more about Professor Shy Guy at shyguy.website. The script editor was Mandy Oquendo. This episode was directed by Dino Andrade and produced by Dino Andrade, Mandy Oquendo, and Ben Paddon. If you have enjoyed the show, please consider leaving a positive review on Apple Podcasts and sharing the show on social media. You can also read the original webcomic at jumpleads.zone and support production of the show by going to patreon.com/benpaddon.